In space, there are things that we've never actually seen, but that we know should be there. Dark matter, for example, which we know must exist, but only due to the effects it has on the universe around it, not because we look into the sky and instantly see it. On the other hand, however, there are phenomena that have been seen or heard, even though science says they shouldn't really be there, or that they're not expected to be there. So what gives? This is Unveiled, and today we're exploring four unexplained things that scientists have seen in space.
Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more fascinating content.
In the 21st century, we're spoiled for choice when it comes to state-of-the-art space and science initiatives. Whether it's the Hubble Telescope, which takes high-definition pictures of the universe, the Spitzer Space Telescope, which captures infrared radiation from obscure space structures, or the Chandra X-ray Observatory, which provides X-ray images of space in all its glory. It all helps to improve our knowledge. And those are just the predominantly NASA ventures. Nowadays, while NASA is still the biggest and best-funded space agency out there, there are various others that are hot on their heels, including China's CNSA, India's ISRO, and Europe's ESA. Regardless of who's running the experiments, though, they've helped scientists to find better-than-ever answers to some of our oldest questions, including how old the universe is and how it formed in the first place. However, sometimes the cutting-edge equipment sees things that can't quite be explained, things that don't quite fit with conventional theories. In 1912, Victor Hess made the Nobel Prize-winning discovery of cosmic rays when he observed radiation entering Earth from outside the atmosphere. Cosmic rays are charged particles that can form in the sun, but also out of other especially energetic events in space. For the most part, researchers have a good understanding of them. But ultra-high-energy cosmic rays, or UHECRs, are a different ballgame and remain a mystery. And in 1991, astronomers at the University of Utah recorded a cosmic ray so powerful that it equaled the kinetic energy of a baseball traveling at 60 miles an hour, an incomprehensible measure for a single atomic nucleus. This was so shocking and unexpected, in fact, that the UHECR in question was nicknamed the Oh My God particle. Researchers have no idea where this particle and particles like it could be coming from, so it could be that the OMG came from outside or inside the Milky Way. But regardless, we also don't know what caused it. Really though, it's more than just not knowing what event could have caused these particles, because by some measurements, they shouldn't even be possible. Chiefly, we don't know how the protons can even reach the speeds of the Oh My God particle. Protons traveling above what's known as the Griessen-Zaltzeppen-Kuzmin limit, which the OMG was, should naturally lose speed by interacting with the cosmic microwave background. But the OMG wasn't doing that. It's been said then that the Oh My God particle seems to break the laws of special relativity, and scientists simply can't explain it. While particle science is a relatively new field, however, we've been studying the stars since ancient times. And yet, star KIC-846-2852, also known as Boyajian star after the astronomer Tabitha S. Boyajian, has been widely called the most mysterious star in the universe. Even the world's leading experts have been stumped by it. The star itself has been known about for centuries. But in 2015, it was Boyajian who first noted how strange the light coming off of it was. For one, the star experiences regular dimming of up to 22%. A massive change, and one that can't possibly be caused by a nearby planet, as it's said that even a planet the size of Jupiter would barely cover 1% of the light. Additionally, the periods of dimming have no discernible pattern, and they come from different parts of the star, so it can't possibly be a single large blockade that's causing it. What's stranger still is that by using archived data, astronomers have noticed that Boyajian's star has been growing dimmer overall, too, with the changes taking place over just decades, rather than the millions of years we might expect. Many theories have been put forward, but none can truly explain every abnormality seen here, which has led some to seriously consider whether alien megastructures could be at play, affecting the light as they pass. But the most prominent theory is that it's dust clouds that are causing the dimming, although the prospect of cosmic dust brings about other questions too. Stars with dust around them are usually younger stars, but Boyajian's star is quite old. So why is it bucking the trend? Plus, the dust should have been blown away by now, but it remains. so it must be replenishing. But how? And still, it's been said that the amount of dust needed for this explanation to work is a cloud about the size of the moon. Not impossible, but again, unusual. So it's little wonder that astronomers continue to monitor Boyajian's star so closely. One thing that astronomers have on their side with stars, however, is that they at least are relatively simple to track, while some other objects pass by so fast that we can barely see them. That's what happened with Oumuamua, the first observed object that came from outside our solar system. Unfortunately, when it was spotted in 2017, astronomers had only a small time frame to view the infamous object before it flew past Earth and back out toward the outer planet's orbits and beyond. As such, Oumuamua was notoriously tricky to classify and remains mostly unexplained. It may have been a comet, but no cometary tail was recorded. It could have been an asteroid, except it gave off 10 times more light than asteroids usually do. According to the Harvard astronomer Avi Loeb, it could have been a passing alien spacecraft. While there's yet another theory that Oumuamua comes from another world in another star system, but a world that's not unlike Pluto, and that it's made of nitrogen ice. The Yale astronomer Gregory Laughlin, however, has noted that, quote, "None of the theories are a slam dunk. The apparent uniqueness of Oumuamua is what's caused most of the confusion and debate. All theories except Loeb's quickly suggest that we should be seeing many more objects just like this in space. But we aren't. And now that it's no longer close enough to us, we may never know for sure exactly what the cigar-shaped something was." Finally, though, we know that not all strangeness in space is seen with our eyes. Some of it is heard, in a manner of speaking. We, of course, also know that space is a vacuum that sound itself can't travel through, but radio waves can. And a strange case of that is what NASA heard in 2006. A team had sent up its ARCADE machine, with the acronym ARCADE standing for Absolute Radiometer for Cosmology, Astrophysics, and Diffuse Emission, to measure radio signals coming from the cosmos. They had expected that detecting the signals might have been difficult, but actually, it was easy, as one came through loud and clear and 6 times louder than it should have been. The signal was swiftly dubbed the Space Roar. To date, no one knows where it comes from, and indeed, it appears to be coming from all angles. But again, there are theories, largely split into 2 camps. The generally deemed less likely idea is that it's from within the Milky Way, and the generally believed more likely theory is that it's from outside our galaxy. Slightly more specifically, researchers believe it could be a byproduct of the earliest stars in the universe, or that it may have originated from a large cluster of different galaxies. But the data is by no means clear. More than 15 years later then, and this one strange measurement remains a mystery. Another unsolved problem in astrophysics. Despite the mysterious nature of all of these cases, however, they're still extremely important. They force us to fix existing theories and to rethink what we thought we knew. And that's all part of improving our knowledge on how the universe works. No scientist or astronomer would ever claim that we know it all already. And as our technology improves, you can bet that there will be more such anomalies uncovered in the coming years and decades. For now, though, let's view them all as opportunities. Whether it's massive cosmic rays, unexpected space roars, stars that don't behave as we expect them to, or here and gone again interstellar objects, they could all lead to a major breakthrough one day. And those are 4 unexplained things that scientists have seen in space.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.